Yeah, Scott, thanks. Some interesting headlines from Richard Clarida, the vice chairman of the Federal Reserve Open Market Committee Federal Reserve Board, pardon me. And he is saying the economy is in a very good place, but he's also telling us what his criteria would be for cutting rates. And they are two-part. There's two parts to them. One, a persistent shortfall in inflation below the Fed's 2% target. And second, material downside risk to the U.S. outlook from either the global economy or financial development. So maybe there's a subtle pushing back there on how much the market has priced in a rate cut. He's saying, look, there's two criteria here, and maybe there's a long way to go, though he doesn't say that. On the other side, there's a pretty high bar for a rate hike. He says fiscal policy continues to support growth in 2019, and wages do not signal cost push pressures, the recent rise in wages. Inflation, he says, remains muted. The prime age participation, that's the participation rate of people 25 to 54, he says may still have some more room to run. All of that means potential output could be higher than current estimates. Add to that, productivity growth may have picked up. All of this tells me of a Fed official who wants to see the economy run, doesn't want to clamp down on higher growth because, he says, the supply side of the economy grew faster than expected in 2018 and in the first quarter of 2019. So maybe a bit more hawkish on the cut, but very dovish on the idea of when the Fed might increase interest rates, Scott.
Yeah, interesting stuff. I mean, everything the Fed says these days, Steve, just given what the market's done and where interest rates have gone, nice little bounce today,
yeah.
But there are so many concerns out there.
Right.
Now, all of a sudden, the drumbeat's like, Fed's got to cut, Fed's got to cut. Dr. J saying they should cut twice.
Well, when you get out on the end of that limb, you know, it gets thin. And so people are really interested in any little comment from any Fed official. There's a talk about whether or not, you know, bond yields have now hit the lows that they're going to low, and there's more resistance now for them to going lower from here. So I think the markets are very interested in what the Fed has to say. I will point out, Scott, no mention of trade by Richard Clarida. So that's not, at least in this speech, though I would imagine it is high on the mind of Fed officials.